morning, my dear students. Today we are going to see how to determine the maximum value of Kc that can be used for a given proportional controller using board stability criteria. At the end of the class, you will be able to draw board diagram for the given system, and from that board diagram, how to find the maximum value of the controller by using board stability criteria. So these things we are going to discuss. We know that board diagram consists of two plots. First plot is magnitude plot, that is nothing but log AR versus log omega, and second one is phase shift plot, that is phi versus log omega. So first one is log plot, whereas second one is semi logarithmic plot. So you can draw board diagrams on log plot and semi log plot, or you can also draw on ordinary rectangular graph sheets. So the method is same everywhere. Only difference is if you use log plot or semi log plot, directly AR omega values we can use. Whereas if you use rectangular graph, you have to convert the log AR values and you have to convert log omega values, then only you can use. Now we'll see how to find these values for the given system and how to determine the maximum value of Kc for the given control system from the open loop transfer function. Okay, here the given system is using board method, calculate the maximum Kc that can be used for a control system having open loop transfer function g of s equal to Kc into e power minus 0.5 s by 2s plus 1. So this is given. See here, if you observe this system, here what they have given is, even though they have taken closed loop control system, they have mentioned only open loop transfer function. Here the first term is Kc, that means in the given control system, proportional controller is used, and we are asked to find the maximum value of this Kc by using the given formulas. This Kc value we need to find out. Now we'll write the given transfer function without considering the controller. Then it will become g of s equal to 1 by 2s plus 1 into e power minus 0.5s. See here, next step is we have to convert this given system into two parts. The first part we call it as system 1, that is 1 by 2s plus 1, and second part we call it as system 2, that is e power minus 0.5s. So here this is first system and this is our second system. So in this way two systems we have to split. Now for these two systems separately we calculate the AR values and phi values, then we'll find the overall AR and overall phi for the given system. Now coming to the first system is in the form of general first order system. We know that general first order system transfer function is given by s 1 by tau s plus 1, and its AR value is nothing but 1 by root over 1 plus tau square omega square, and phase shift phi equal to tan inverse of minus tau omega. We know this formula. If you do not know how we got, these are explained separately in a separate video. So there you can see here we got AR and phi values. Now we calculate the AR and phi for the given system. See, given system is 1 by tau s plus 1. The format of both the systems are same. Only difference is in place of tau, here we have 2. That means for our system, tau value is equivalent to 2. Remaining all will be same. So this is what we have. From this, we calculate the AR value and tau value. We know that AR equal to 1 by root over 1 plus tau square omega square. Here we got tau value as 2. So we'll have 1 plus 2 square omega square. Similarly, phi we get it as tan inverse of minus 2 omega. Only in place of tau, we have to change the value. Remaining all will be same. So this is how we got AR and phi values for the system 1. Now we calculate the AR and phi values for the system 2 also. So system 2 looks like a general transportation delay system or pure dead system. For pure dead system, transfer function is given as e power minus tau ds, and its AR value is equivalent to 1 and phi equal to minus tau d into omega. This is the general formula. Now the given system is the e power minus 0.5s, so which is similar to the transportation delay system. Only difference is here we have 0.5. In place of tau d, we got 0.5. So we substitute this tau d value in this AR and phi formulas. AR, there is no tau d term, so it won't change. Its value will be 1 only. Whereas phi value will become, in place of tau d, you can substitute minus 0.5. So it will become minus 0.5 omega. In this way, AR2 and phi2 we have to calculate. Once we get AR2 and phi2, then we have to calculate the overall AR value and overall phi values. Overall AR is nothing but the product of individual ARs. Similarly, overall phi is nothing but the summation of the individual phis. Therefore, AR will become AR1 into AR2. Similarly, phi will become phi1 plus phi2. Already we have calculated AR1 value and AR2 value. Similarly, phi1 value and phi2 value. So simply we have to substitute here. We got AR1 value as 1 by root over 1 plus 2 square omega square. And AR2 value we got 1. So there is no change. And phase shift value we got it as phi equal to tanwards of minus 2 omega. That is for first system. And for second system we got it as minus 0.05 omega. So two phi values we got, both we have to add. Okay, then we'll get the overall phi. So in this way, overall AR and overall phi values we have to calculate. Once we get the overall AR and overall phi, the next step is we have to assume different values of omega and we have to calculate the corresponding AR values and phi values. From that generated data, we have to draw the Bohr diagram. So here, we assumed omega values between 0.01 to 10. So we have taken various values of omega and we have substituted in AR formula. So AR is for overall system 1 by root over 1 plus 4 omega square. In this, if you substitute omega value as 0.1, we will get 0.98081. Okay, this is how we get. So this is what we get. If you take omega value at 0.1, we will get this. Similarly, if you substitute this omega value in this formula here and here, if we get phi value as minus 0.24739, in this way you will get. See, same manner we have to assume different values of omega, like 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 8, 1 up to 10 you can take. Then if you substitute a here in AR and phi formulas, then you will get this all ARs. This all ARs you will get. Similarly, this all phi values you will get. Okay, in this way, AR and phi values for different values of omega we have to generate. Once you get AR and phi, then we calculate the log AR value and log omega. If you draw the diagram on ordinary graph sheet or semi-log graph sheet, then you have to do these conversions also. If you use log-log plot, no need to do any conversion. Here, and one other important thing is, always phi should be in degrees in Bohr diagram. So whatever the type of diagram you use, compulsory phi should be in degrees. So always you have to convert radians into degrees. So you have to use this AR and this phi for drawing the graph. So in this way you have to generate the data. Once you generate the data, the next step is you have to draw the Bohr diagram. So from this values, here we have constructed a graph between AR versus omega on log-log plot. This is log-log plot, that's where directly AR and omega values were taken. Similarly here, phi values. Phi is ordinary scale, whereas omega is logarithmic scale. So it is semi-log plot. So we have taken top one log-log plot, bottom one semi-log plot. If you use ordinary graph sheet, here this omega values you have to convert into logarithm. Similarly AR also you have to plot here log AR. Instead of AR you have to plot log AR. Here instead of omega you have to plot log omega. But there is no change in phi. Like this, by using the data you have to draw the Bohr diagram. So for our data we will get the Bohr diagrams like this, two plots. The next step is, for determining the maximum value of Kc, we have to find the crossover frequency. For finding crossover frequency, we have to use phase lag diagram. This diagram we use first. Crossover frequency is the frequency where phase lag is minus 180. That means at minus 180, we have to check where this minus 180 we got. So here we got minus 180. So from this minus 180, we have to draw a horizontal line till it touches the curve. Wherever it touches, that line we have to take. So here we got. So that means this point or this frequency, we call it as crossover frequency. This is our crossover frequency. Now at this particular crossover frequency, we have to calculate the corresponding AR values. For that, you have to draw a vertical line from this crossover frequency till it touches the curve, top curve. So here it is touching top curve. So from this point, you have to draw the horizontal line, so that we will get the AR value. So here we got AR value. Amplitude ratio is A. Here we have taken it as A in this case. So that value you have to find from the graph. So I am repeating the process once again. First we have to find the crossover frequency. For that, at minus 180 you have to draw a horizontal line. Wherever it touches the curve, that point you have to find the frequency. That frequency is called as the crossover frequency. Same frequency, you have to find the corresponding AR value. For that, you have to draw the vertical line till it touches the curve. From there, that point, you have to draw a horizontal line. Then you will get the corresponding AR value at the crossover frequency. So in this way, you have to find. So once you get crossover frequency and AR at the crossover frequency, okay, next step is very simple. So here we got from our diagram, board diagram, we got crossover frequency as 3.43 and amplitude ratio at the crossover frequency is A, that is 0.14248 we got. Then to find the maximum value of Kc, we have to use the formula Kc max equal to 1 by amplitude ratio at the crossover frequency. So this is 1 divided by amplitude ratio at the crossover frequency is 0.14248, that we have to write here. Similarly, Kc maximum, see, from this we will get the 1 by 0.14 is nothing but 0.69, 6.9325. So here we calculated the maximum value of Kc for the given control system. So this is how we have to calculate the maximum value of Kc for the given control system. Okay, steps are very simple. First we have to find the crossover frequency from the board diagram. Then we have to find the corresponding AR at the crossover frequency. Then we have to use this formula Kc max equal to 1 by AR at the crossover frequency. By using this formula, we can calculate the ultimate value or maximum value of the Kc for the given system. This is same for any system. So this is how we have to calculate. Thank you.